Hello everyone, welcome to Geeks for Geeks. I am Chaitanya Munje and in this video we will be creating a tic-tac-toe game application in online mode. In previous video, we have built both single player as well as multiplayer game in offline mode. In this video, we will be building an online mode game application. So here is the demo which I have already created. We will take a look at this demo. So inside this, we will simply click on a multiplayer. After that, we have to select online mode. Then from one device, we will be creating a code. And in the second device, we will be adding the similar code and we will then click on join. Now we will start playing the game. In the emulator, the player which is playing the game in the emulator have won the game. So we can get to see the "you have won the game" message here. And in the next device, we can get to see the messages opponent have won the game. Now similar applications we are going to build inside our Android Studio. Now let's move towards working in the Android Studio. We have already created a project in our previous video. We are going to continue to the same project. As we discussed, so we are going to use Firebase as a backend. So first of all, we will connect our Android application with the Firebase. So for connecting our application to Firebase, we simply have to go inside our browser, navigate to console.firebase.com, and inside that we have to click on add a project. If you are creating the project first time, then you will get to see this type of screen. In here we have to name our project and we simply have to click on continue to proceed further. After that we have to click on continue to move forward. Then we have to select our Google Analytics account. After that, we simply have to click on create project to create our new project in Firebase. Once our project has been created, we simply have to click on continue. After that, we are adding this inside our Android project, so we have to click on Android. Inside this, we have to add the package name of our application. So to get the package name of our application, we have to go to our Android Studio project. Inside our any of this, that is main activity.java Kotlin file, we have to copy our package name from here. This one is the package name, that is com dot, and here we have to add our package name. After that we have to name our app. And we simply have to register our application. After registering our application, it will prompt to download a Google services.json file. So we have to download this file. After downloading that file, we can get to see in the downloads folder. We have to simply copy this file. And we have to paste this inside our Android Studio. So for pasting this file, we have to simply navigate to project from Android tab. And here inside our app folder, we have to paste our file. Make sure that your file name should be Google services.json and it should not contain any extension like 17, 16 or something like that. It may produce some error. So keep the file name as Google services.json and click on OK to add this file. After that, we simply have to go again inside our Android tab. As we are using internet, so we have to add the permission for using internet. Now for storing the data inside our Firebase console, we are using Firebase real-time database. So to add the dependencies of Firebase real-time database, we simply have to go on tools and we have to click on Firebase. Inside this, we have to go on Firebase real-time database. And here, after adding the Google services.json file, we can get to see option as connected. After that, we simply have to click on add real-time database. So it will add all the dependencies which are required to us. We have to simply click on accept changes to add the dependencies. After that, we also have to add one more dependency for Firebase database. So we will go inside our build.gradle file. First of all, we will wait for this Gradle to sync, and then we'll add again one dependency. So this dependency will be the similar. The change is here is we simply have to add KTX and change the version. After adding this, we simply have to click on sync now to sync our project. Now, as we see inside our demo project, after clicking on the multiplayer, we are getting to see two buttons, that is online and offline mode. So we will create a new activity for this one. So for creating new activity, we have to go inside our Java folder, package name, then right click on it. We simply have to click on new activity and select activity as empty activity. Here we have to name our activity as multiplayer. Multiplayer game selection activity, and we have to click on finish to create our activity. Now inside this activity, we will create two buttons. So first of all, we will change the root layout from constraint to relative. After that, we will create a text view. Specify width as match parent, height trap content. We will align our text to center, gravity as center. Text size as 20 sp. Text color as black. ID as we will slightly increase the text size. After that, we will create two buttons. Specify width as wrap content, height also as wrap content. All caps as false. Align this button below to our head. After that, we have to create again one more button. Specify width and height as wrap content. Text as offline. ID as. Layout center horizontal as true. Margin top as 30 dB. Now we have created the UI for our activity multiplayer game selection. So after that, we have to initialize this buttons and inside our Kotlin file. So inside this, we will create variables for our buttons, that is online button. After that, we have to initialize these buttons with their IDs. So we will add onClick listener to these buttons. Along with that, inside our main activity.kotlin file, we have to change this, that is multiplayer. So here we have to change the activity name. That is here, the activity name will be multiplayer game selection activity. And we simply have to use this code again. Inside the online mode, we will add here single user as false, and inside the online button we will create a new activity, that is online code generator. And similarly in the offline mode also we have to use single user as false, start activity, and here we have to simply call gameplay activity. Now we will create this activity which will be to generate the code, that is in the output screen we can get to see, that is here this activity for generating code and to join the game. We will be creating it with the name as online code generator activity. So we will copy this name. Now for creating activity we simply have to go to our package name, right click, new activity, empty activity, and we have to paste the name. After that we simply have to click on finish to create our activity. Now this error will be resolved. Now we have completed the coding for this activity, so we will close this one. Now we will move towards creating the UI for the code generator activity. So firstly we will change the root layout to relative. Our code generator activity will be this one for generating the code and joining the same code. So firstly we will create a text view, specify width as match parent, height wrap content, text as text alignment as center, text size as 30 sp, gravity as center, margin 10 dp, text color as black, margin top as 30 dp, increase little bit more. Here we will remove the margin. After that we will give ID. After that we will create a button. Firstly we will create edit text which will be used to generate the new code space and enter the code which the user has to join. Specify width as match parent, height wrap content, add below, that is to our PV head, specify hint as enter code, margin start as 30 dp, margin end as 30 dp, specify id as after that we will create two buttons, specify width and height as wrap content. Below to our code edit text, center horizontal as true, text all caps as false, specify margin top as 20 dp. For that we will again create a new button which will be for join, width and height as wrap content. Below create button, specify id to this button, now we have created our buttons. Along with that we will also create a progress bar, that is a loading indicator which is used to display the loading when the code is created. Specify width and height as wrap content, layout center in parent, we will align it to the center of our screen. Initially we are making the visibility as gone, specify id as gone. Now we have completed the XML part of our code generator activity. Now we will move towards the initializing all our variables, that is UI variables. So firstly, we will create variable for our head TV. Then our code edit text. Then our create button. Create code button. Then join code button. It will be progress bar. After that, we will initialize all our variables. After that, we will create variables, that is code maker and others. So we will create variable and initialize it as false, as it is a boolean. After that, we will create another variable, that is for code, and initialize it with null. Now we will create a string, that is key value. And initialize it with null. Now we will add on click listeners to our two buttons, that is create code button. And we will add on click listener to our join code button. Now we will create a separate method which will be used to redirect our user to the gameplay activity. So for the gameplay activity in online mode, we will create a new activity. We will go to package name, right click on it, new, and then create activity, empty activity. We will name our activity as online multiplayer game activity, and we have to click on finish to create our new activity. Now we will move towards the online code generator activity. Inside this, we will create a new function and we will name it as function accepted. This function will be called when the another user, that is the second user, accepts the request of the first user. So this function will open the online multiplayer game activity to start the gameplay. In this function, we first of all start our activity. Now in this, we have to specify the name of our activity which we have to launch. Now after starting our activity, we have to make the visibility of our all the function, but UI variables, that is buttons, our head text view and the edit text as a visible. So we will change the visibility. Now we have to change the visibility for each of our views, that is first one will be the join button, then head TV, then edit text, and our loading progress bar. So we will change here at a join button, then code edit text, then head text view, and after that we will change to loading progress bar. Inside loading progress bar we have to make a visibility as gone. Now our function accepted has been completed. Now we will create a new function, that is value available. This function will be called when the code is already present inside our database. So for that we is creating a is value available function. Now in this function we will pass our snapshot, that is Firebase snapshot, data snapshot, and along with that we will pass our code, which we will collect from the edit text which is added by the user, and we will returning in the form of boolean. In this we will first of all create a variable, that is data, and we will get it from the snapshot.children. Inside this we will call data for each method, and in this we will create a variable value. And here we will check if the value is equal to code. In this condition we will change key value to and we will simply return true in this case. If this condition does not satisfy, then we simply have to return false. Now we have completed the isValue function as well. Now we will move towards adding the onClick listener to each offer button. So firstly we will add onClick listener for our create button. Here we will firstly initialize our code as null. After that we'll add code found as false, then check temp is equal to true, then key value as null. After that we will get the text from our code edit text. And after that we will make the visibility of all our views to gone. First one will be for create code button, then join code button, then our head TV, code edit text, and loading progress bar. Here we will change join code button, head TV, code edit text, and last one will be for loading progress bar. And in loading progress bar we have to change visibility as visible. After that we will check for the code. If code is not equal to null, and code is not empty, in this condition we will change is code maker true, and we will call our Firebase database, and we will get the instance of it, that is Firebase database get instance dot reference. We will create the child as codes, and we'll call add value event listener method. And in this first of all we will call the on data change function. Inside this function we have to create a variable, that is var check. Here we have to check if the value is already available or not. So we will call is value available method, and inside this we will pass our snapshot and our code. After that we will run a handler. Here we will check if check is true. In this condition that the code is already present inside our Firebase database. So we will simply change the visibility of all our views, that is create button visibility to visible. For others as well, we will change the visibility, that is join button, head TV, code ADT and loading progress bar. Join button, code ADT, head TV, then loading progress bar. In loading progress bar, we will change visibility as gone. Here we will add the else condition. In the else condition, we will simply add our Firebase data, call Firebase database dot get instance dot reference dot child. And in this, we will simply push our code. And here we will again check if is value available and we will pass this to it. After that, we will check temp as false. Then we will again run a handler. Inside post delete, we will call our accepted method, which is called when the code is accepted. And we will simply display a toast message. That is, please don't go back. After that, for handler, we will simply run a duration of 300 milliseconds. And for this handler, we will run duration as 2000 milliseconds, that is 2 seconds. Along with that, we have to implement onCancel method. So we can implement this by simply clicking on this, then click on implement members and then click on OK to implement the onCancel. In this method, we don't have to do anything. After this completion of the if part, we will simply write else condition as well. In else condition, we will simply change the visibility of our button and all the views, that is to visible. Simply for other views, that is join code button, head TV, code ADT and loading progress bar. Join code button, head TV, code edit text, loading progress bar. In loading progress bar, we will change visibility as gone. And in this, we will simply display a toast message, that is the code entered by user is not correct. So we will simply display a toast message as please enter a valid code. Now we have completed the create code button on click listener, so we will minimize this. After that, we will move towards the join code button. Inside this also, we will firstly initialize our code to null. After that, we will change code found as false, then check temp as true. Key value as null. After that, we will get the data from our code edit text. We will check for the code if the code is not equal to null. Not empty. In this condition, we will simply change the visibility. Firstly, we will add else condition. In else condition, what we have to do is we simply have to display the toast message. That please enter a valid code. Inside if condition, we will simply change the visibility here. Now we will simply change the visibility for other views as well. That is join code button, head TV, code edit text and loading progress bar. So we will change as join code button, code edit text, that is, and after that is a head TV and loading progress bar. In loading progress bar, we will change the visibility to visible. After that, we will change is code maker to false. As we are joining with the code, then we will call Firebase database dot get instance dot reference. We will get a reference of our course. Value event listener. Inside value event listener, we will call on data change method. Inside this method, we will first of all check if the value is already available or not. And we will pass snapshot and our code. After that, we will again run a handler. Inside this, we will check if the data is true. And here we will change the code found as true if the code is found by the user. Here we will add the duration for our handler, 2000 milliseconds, which will be 2 seconds. After changing the code found to true, we will simply call accepted method as the code has been accepted. And here we will change the create code button dot visibility view dot visible. Now we will add the another views, that is join code button, head TV, code edit text and loading progress bar. Join code button, head TV, code edit text, loading progress bar, and we will change the visibility to gone here. And we will add else loop. If the code is not found, in this case, we simply have to display a toast message and change the visibility for our views. Create code button dot visibility. We will add other variables, that is join code button, head TV, code edit text and loading progress bar. So join code button, code edit text, head TV, loading progress bar, and we will change visibility to gone for the progress bar. After that, we will simply have to display a toast message that the code entered by user is invalid. Here we simply have to implement the another method, that is on cancel. So we will implement this method. Now we have completed the coding for our, that is code creation and code exception part, that is to create a code and join the with the code. Now we will simply move towards the next activity, that is online game player activity. We will close this one. And here we have to change the UI, that is first we will change the route layout to relative layout. Now the UI for our gameplay, which will be the same as we have created in the previous part. So in the previous part we have created, that is our activity underscore gameplay. This UI will be the same, so we will simply copy this UI. And we will simply use this one here. The only difference here is that we will change the activity name here, that is context will be online multiple, and here we will get the error as button click is not created function. So we will simply click on this red bulb and we will create this method inside our online multiplayer game activity. Now after creating this UI, we will initialize all our variables, as we have already initialized this variable inside our, that is gameplay activity. So we will simply copy these variables along with its name. We are using all the variables and we will simply paste it in the next activity. Along with that, the ID will also be same, so we can use the same initialization in our online multiplayer game activity. Now we have created variables as well as initialized all our variables. Now we have to create one more variable, that will be for isMyMove. And we will initialize it to the false, that is code maker. Now here these variables are not being used, so they are showing in a gray color. After initializing all our variables, we will firstly add the onclick listener for our reset button, dot set onclick listener, and here we will are calling the reset function. So firstly we will create a reset function. Inside reset function, we will firstly change the player one. That is, we will clear our player one ArrayList. Simply, we will clear our player two ArrayList. After that, we will clear our empty cells array. Then we will change active user to one. After that, we will run simply a for loop from 1 to 9. And here we will simply create a new variable, that is for our button selected. And inside this, we will specify the ID, that is box one button. These are our the button ID that we are specifying, that is one for box one button, two for box two button. Similarly, we will be creating for other buttons, that is up to 9. We will change the ID along with the button variable. Now we will change the variable for our buttons, that is box 4 button, box 9 button, and at last we will add a simply a else condition, and inside it we will simply specify our box 1 button. After that we have to enable button selected dot is enabled equal to true. After that we have to add text to our button selected as empty, score 1 TV, we have not created the variable, that is player 1 TV, player 1 TV dot text. Player 1 count. Similarly for player 2, After that, we have to change is my move is equal to is code maker. We have to check if is code maker. Then we simply have to call Firebase database dot get instance dot get reference reference dot child. Inside this we have to specify as data child. Here we have to pass our code and we simply have to call a remove value method to remove this value from our Firebase. Now we have completed the reset function, which will be used to reset our game. After that, we have to call create a new function, that is button disable, which will use to disable all our buttons. So we will simply create a new function, that is button disable. Inside this function, we will run a for loop. And we will create a new variable, that is button selected. After that, inside this, we will first of all change the ID. That is, we will specify ID for each button, that is box per button. Similarly, up to the 9 buttons. We will change the ID and button variable. We will change the button variable to and at last we will simply add a else condition. That is box one button. After that we will check button selected dot is enabled as true. If it is true, then we simply have to enable it to false. Now we have completed the button disable function as well. After that, we have to create a new function, that is remove code. So which will be used to remove the code from our Firebase database. So it will prevent the storage. So we will, in this, we will simply check if it is a code maker. If it is a code maker, then we simply have to call Firebase database get instance dot reference dot child, and inside this we have to specify the codes dot child, specify the key value, and we simply have to call remove value method to remove that specific value. Now this method will be used to remove the code. After that we have to create a function, that is for the disable reset. This will be used to reset our disable. So we will simply create a disable reset function. In this we simply call reset button dot is enabled as false. After that we will run a handler dot post delay, and inside this we will run a runable. In runable we will simply set reset button dot is enabled to true. We have to delay this task by 2000 milliseconds. After that we will call the on back press method. This method will be called when the user tries to press the back button. Inside this we simply have to call a remove code method, that is it will remove the code from our Firebase database, and here we will check if it is a code maker. If it is a code maker, then we will simply call Firebase database dot get instance dot reference dot child, and here we will change add the pass our code and simply call the remove value method to remove our code. After that we will simply call the exit process method and pass the 0 to 8. Now we have completed the onBackTrace method as well. Now we will create one more method, which will be for updating our database. We will call the method name as updateDatabase, and in that we will pass our cell ID, which will be our integer value. Inside this we will simply call Firebase database dot get instance reference dot child, and here we will pass our data. We will pass child as our code, call push, then set value as cell ID. This method will update the cell inside our Firebase database. Now inside our onCreate method, we will first of all initialize our Firebase database. So for that, first we will call Firebase database. Dot get instance dot reference dot child. Inside this we will pass our data. Add child event listener. Inside this we will first of all call our onChildAdded method, or we can simply click on this red bulb. First of all we will have to click on this object, then click on red bulb, click on implement, select all to implement all our methods. This will create the methods which were required. After that, inside our child added method, we will first of all create a variable as data, and here we will check our snapshot value by using snapshot.value method. And here we will check is my move. If it is true, in this case we will specify is my move as false, and we will call a move online. This method we are going to create, so in this we will pass our data dot to string and our is my move variable. We will create a function for it, that is my move. Function will be the move online, and in this we will be passing the data in the format of string and move, which will be our boolean value. We will be completing this one as well. So first of all we will check for the onChildAdded function. Inside onChildAdded we are checking for the move online, and in the else condition we will be simply making is my move as true, and we are calling move online method, and we are passing our data dot to stream, and then we are passing is my move, that is boolean variable. After that we simply have to go to our on child removed function. We don't have to do anything with the inside the on child added removed method. In removed method we have to implement it. We don't have to do in on child mode, on cancelled, and on child change method. Now inside this on child removed method we simply have to call our reset to reset our game, and we simply have to display our toast message and specify the message as game reset dot line short dot show. After that we will move towards our move online method. Inside this method we simply have to create a variable for our audio, that audio file which we have already added in our raw folder. We have seen this by for adding a new audio file inside our raw folder, so we will create a variable for it, that is media player dot create. We'll pass the context as this. We will specify the sound file here. After that we will check for our move. After that, we will create a variable that is button selected. And here we will specify as button. Button selected. Inside this, we will specify with our box worth button. Simply we will add for the other as well, that is from 1 to 9. We will change our cell ID. Here we will change the variable for our button. And at last we simply have to call the else block. And we have to specify as a box one button. After that, we simply have to call button selected dot text, and we have to specify the text as O. After that, we have to that is player turn. Here in our gameplay we also had seen that the turn is been also displayed, so we will simply add the text view, that is the turn text view. So inside our online multiplayer game we will add another text view above this one. We will create a simple text view, specify with as match parent, height, wrap content, ID as. So this text view will be used to indicate which player's turn is going on. Text all caps as false, alignment as center, specify margin top as 30 dp, text color as black, text size as 15 sp, After this, we have to initialize this text view inside our online multiplayer game activity. So we will create a variable for this one as well. That is turn TV. After that, we will simply initialize this variable. Now we will use that variable here. In this case, we will simply set our turn TV dot text. This one will be the turn for our player one. After that, we will change the button selected text color dot parse color. This will be the color for our button selected button. Then we will simply add this player 2 dot add data dot to int. After that, we will simply add this to empty cells as well. That is data dot to int. Along with that, we will call the audio dot start method to start our audio. Now we will run a handler. Dot post delayed method, inside it we will run a runnable, and in this we will simply call audio dot release method to release our audio for the duration of 200 milliseconds. After that we will simply call button selected dot is enabled and specify it as a false. After that we will call a method that is check winner. So we will create a method for check winner. This method we have also created in our previous video, which is for offline mode. This method will be used to check the winner. Now we have completed the move online method as well, so we will minimize this one. And along with We also completed the Firebase method. Now we will move towards our check winner method. Inside this, the check winner method will return an integer value. Inside the check winner, we will create a variable for our audio file, that is audio, and we will specify the media player dot create, specify the sound file as success. Inside this, we will add the if condition, and here we will check, that is player one dot contains. Here we are checking the conditions. If the game player one wins, then the successful condition will be for cell 1, 2, 3, then 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Either it will be in a diagonal, that is 1, 5, and 9, or in an opposite diagonal. So we will be checking for each condition. If the player one contains 1, and then player one dot contains 2, player one dot contains 3. So we will check this for 3 first, and then we will again check for the other condition as well, that player one dot contains next condition will be for 1. Player one dot contains 4, 7, 1, 4, and 7. Now we will simply copy this one, and we will simply change the integer value inside it. That is, first one will be 1, 2, 3, then 1, 4, 7. After that, it will be 3, 6, 9. So we will simply change the integer value, that is 3, 6, and 9. After that, we will change it to 7, 8, 9. Then we will change it for 4, 5, 6. After that, it will be for 1, 5, 9. After that, we will be adding for 3, 5, 7. Then we will add it for 2, 5, 8, which will be the last condition. 2, 5, and at last it will be 8. Now we will remove the last OR condition. Inside this condition, we will simply increment our player one count by 1. We will call button disable method to disable our buttons, calling the audio dot start method to start our audio. After that, we will call a disable reset to disable our reset. We will simply run a handler dot post delete, running a runnable init. Inside this method, we will be releasing our audio for the duration of 4000 milliseconds. Inside this, we will call create a new variable for our alert dialog, which will be build alert dialog dot builder. Inside this, we will be passing our context as this. After that, we will set the title for our alert dialogs as set title as game over. Inside this, we will call build dot set message. We will be setting message as layer one when layer one wins. Do you want to play a game? After that, we'll set a build dot set negative button, and we will set the text as okay, and we will add on click listener. Inside this method, we will call a reset method to reset our game, and we'll simply release our audio. After that, we will call set negative button. Inside this button we will pass the text as exit, and we will call dialog. And we will call audio.release method to release our audio. Then we will call remove code method to remove our code, and we will exit this process by passing integer value as 1. After that we will run a handler dot postgres runnable, and inside this we have to show our dialog, that is build.show. We will delay this task by 2000 milliseconds. After that we simply have to return 1. Now we will check for the else if condition. Inside the else if condition this will be similar, but the difference will be that instead of player 1 we will be checking this for the player 2. So we will simply paste this one here. We will find it by using control F, selecting this variable, then finding by using control F. After that we simply have to click on control R to replace this one. So we will change it with the player 2. Make sure that we are using replace one by one. If we are use replace all, then it will replace all the variables. So we will use simply replace to change it to player 2. Now we will remove this. Now here we will be add opening and closing curly braces. Inside this we will increment player 2 count. After that we will call audio.start method to start our audio. Then we will call button disable function to disable our buttons. Along with that we will also call disable reset method. Here also we will run our handler. Inside runnable method we will be releasing our audio, and we will be setting duration as 4000 milliseconds. After that we will be again creating our dialog, that is alert dialog. The dialog will be the similar, so we will simply use this similar dialog, and instead of winner 1 we will change the player 2 wins here. Rest of the code will be the same. After that, after the handler, we will simply return 1. After this we will check it for empty cells, else if condition for empty cells is if empty cells dot contains, that is all the integers, that is 1, 2, 3 and up to 9. In this condition we will also display our alert dialog box, but the message will be different. Alert dialog dot builder, and here we will be passing the context, that is this. After that we will simply set the title for our dialog box as game draw. In this condition we will be setting dot set message as game draw. And we will specify the message as do you want to play a game. Inside this we will call build.setPositive button. and here we will call audio.release method. After that we will reset our game. Then we will call build.setNegative button. Inside the setNegative button we will be setting text as exit. And inside this we will be calling audio.release. We will be exiting this process by passing as 1. Then we will be calling remove code method to remove our code. After that we will be simply calling build.show to display our alert dialog, and we will be returning 1. After that, if any of this condition does not follow, then we will simply return 0. Now we have completed our check winner function. Now we will be creating another method, which will be our play now method, that is function play now, that is button selected, and it will be our button. And after that inside this function we will be first of all creating variable for our audio file, media player dot create. We will be passing context to it. After that we will be passing sound file as, inside this first of all we will change the text for the button selected dot text. We will specify empty cells dot remove, that is current cell. Inside this we will change the text to dot text. The turn will be for our player 2. After that we will add button selected dot set text color, color dot parse color. After that we will call player1.add current cell. Along with that we will also add it to empty cells current cell. Now we will call audio.start to start our audio file. After that we will call button selected dot is enabled, and we will enable it to false. Then again we will simply run a handler. Then we will call runnable inside it and call audio.release. We will be releasing this audio for the duration of 200 milliseconds. And we will again calling check winner method to check our winner. Now we have completed for the play now function. We will be using this inside our button click, that is this method, button click method. Now we will move towards our button click method. Inside this, first of all, we will check if it is my move or not. If it is a my move, then we will simply create a variable, that is button. Here we will create a variable, that is cell online. And in this, we will run a when loop and we will check for button.id. Box 1. Here we will add the value as sell. We will add the online value, that is online sale value, as 1 for button 1. Similarly we have to do it for the other 9 buttons. We will change the ID. Along with that we will also change the sale ID. After that, we will add the else condition, and inside this we will change sale online as 0. After that, we will change the player turn to false. Then simply run a handler, runnable, to change our player turn as true. We will be delaying this task by the 600 milliseconds. Now we will again calling the playNow method here, and we will be passing our button and the cell, that is cell online. After that, we will be updating our database by calling the update database method, which we already created, and here also we will pass our cell online. Now we have used this method here inside the on button click. Now we have completed the coding part. Now we will simply run our application. Now after running our app, we simply have to go our Firebase console and we have to click on next. We have completed this procedure. We simply have to go to next and continue to console. Now inside our console, we simply have to go to our real-time database. We simply have to click on create database, click on next, and we have to click on start on test mode. We are not using lock mode because we have not provided authentication inside our application. So we will be using start in a test mode and click on enable option to enable our database. Now our database has been created. Inside rule sections, we can get to see the rules of our database, which have already been described for our test mode. Now we will run our app. Inside our code, in the onCreate method, we have to add here our child, that is on which child we have to make query, and inside that we have to pass our code, the value for our code, so that we can add the data to our Firebase database inside the data and then to the specific code, that is the child with the specific code. After that, we have to again run our application and see the output of the application. Now our app has been installed. Now we will take a look at the output of the application. So here is the first device, and in second device we will firstly select multiplayer and then online. And in this we will firstly create a code. On first device, that is in the real device, we will create a code, and on emulator we will be joining it. Now we will play the game. Here is the output of the application. We have get the message, but the message is looking a bit confusing, so we will update the message inside our code. So instead of player 1, when the player 1 wins, that means the user which is playing the game on his device has won. So we will simply write, "You have won." And in case of player 2, we will simply write, "Opponent have won the game." Now we will run the application again and see the output of the application. Now we have built our application, so we will take a look at the output of the application. So here is the firstly is the emulator, then our real device. Now we will simply go to multiplayer and online mode in both the devices. Then we will create a code. On first device, that is on real device, we will be creating a code, and on emulator we will be joining it. So we will start playing the game. Here we can get to see that emulator has been won. So we have got to see the "you have won" message on the emulator, as well as the opponent have won the message on the real device. So this is how we have completed the building of the tic-tac-toe game application. So if you are having any doubts regarding whatever I have explained in this video, do ask in the comment section. For complete code, refer the articles present in the description box below. So do like the video, subscribe to this channel, and thanks for watching.